once I actually asked Tiruchi Swami. I had a very intimate relationship with Tiruchi Swami, with His grace and blessings. He allowed that kind of an intimate relationship with Him. My grandfather used to serve Him. And whenever my grandfather used to take me to Him, He will make me fall at His feet and then He will tell, சாமிக்கு வழி வழி அடிமையா இருக்கணும். Then Tiruchi Swami will laugh. He's like a child. I can still remember. This few people's laughter is just inside my heart. Ramsuratmar, Visiri Swamigal's laughter. Oh God. He will literally roll on the ground and laugh. He used to always carry that coconut shell and fan. He will throw both and then laugh. When he starts laughing. Same way the Tiruchi Swami. When he laughs, the whole being laughs. Then he will bless. Shema Maharinda. I asked him once, Swamiji, how come there is no smell anything of human body? Hey, சன்னியாசிக்கு உடம்புல ஸ்மெல் வரப்படாது. He explained in Tamil, சோறு சுத்தமா இருக்கணும், சோறுதான் ரத்தம் மஜ்ஜை சுக்கலம் ஆகுதுரா, சோறு சுத்தமா இருந்தா இதெல்லாம் சுத்தமா இருக்கும், நாத்தம் இருக்காது. Means, he said that food only becomes blood, bone marrow, semen, that reproductive energy in the system. The food is pure. All this will be pure. There will not be any smell. I have seen an absolute integrity and discipline in his life for the quantity, quality, time of the food. He is yogi by simple living. On time he will come for his breakfast or lunch or dinner, eat only that limited quantity, pure organic sattvic food. He will feed everyone. But he himself will eat only his limited quantity. An amazing yogi. You can have his darshan. Had the fortune of sitting at his feet. Many times having his darshan. From the time I have seen him, maybe I would have seen him first time when I was a kid, maybe, I don't know whether 7 year or 10 year or whatever. But as a kid, I have seen him. That much I remember very clearly because my grandfather used to be a great follower. He used to give food for him and serve him. He stayed in a place called Oyamadam, just opposite to the house I was born and brought up. Before he started the Kailashashram in Bangalore, he used to stay in that Oyamadam. It's a mutt, belongs to Nagarathar. So that time my grandfather, my father's side and mother's side, both of them used to be associated with him. I was describing about Tiruchi Swami and how he taught me. He is extraordinary embodiment of love of the mother, Parashakti, protection of the father. I tell you, it actually happened once. That once I went and told him that I was in Kailashashram, as one of his sannyasi, and I told him that I wanted to leave to start the work I am supposed to do, the reviving the Kailasa. He looked at me and said, "Hey, நீ எனக்கு அடிமை, நான் சொல்றது தான் செய்யணும், நீ நினைச்சதெல்லாம் பண்ண முடியாது." I just fell at his feet literally and said, "சாமி உத்தரவு, சாமி அடிமையா ஏத்துக்கிட்டதே பெருசு, சாமி உத்தரவு." Means I told him that let your command be the ultimate. You accepted me as your slave, that itself is a great thing, greatest blessing. Only your command will be done. And there were few devotees around. He laughed and told them, "Ivan paatan ivana enak ezhi kuduttan." He told them that my grandfather has written and given me to him as his slave. இவன் பாட்டேன் இவனை என்ன எழுதி எனக்கு எழுதி கொடுத்துருக்கான். ஐ டெல் யூ, when great people feel you are theirs, your life will become great. That's all. Nothing more need to be done. And it is not that he stopped me in my work. He only protected me. And then within next few days, on 19, he calls me. I still remember the date. I'll tell you why. He calls me to his place where he sits and meets people. It was 19. He calls me. Morning, early morning. I went to his room and touched his feet, and he said in Tamil, "Dai, okara." He will call me in singular only. Very intimate relationship, and it's a great blessing to be called by them in singular. He told in singular, "Okara, sit." I sat in his presence with a bowing down and covering the mouth with the hands, because when we speak, that saliva should not touch them, should not fall on them, so we cover the face. And I was sitting. One of his disciples, Shivapuri Swami, great Swami, he has his own ashram. He went from his ashram, means Tiruchi Swami's ashram, to start his own ashram on 19th. So every 19th he will come to have darshan of Tiruchi Swami, and they will have closed door conversation. They will not have anyone else in that meeting. But that day he allowed me, he asked me to be there, and Shivapuri Swami came, and as usual he offered the flowers and fell at the feet and did darshan. That's a traditional way of removing the upper cloth and tying it in the hip and then falling at the feet of the Guru, and he did all that. And then Tiruchi Swami, he told Shivapuri Swamiji to sit. He sat one side and I was sitting the other side. Usually when Shivapuri Swami comes, Tiruchi Swami will send everyone out. But that day purposely, after Shivapuri Swami sat, he told me, "Sit." I was about to get up and go out. He said, "Sit, sit." Then he told Shivapuri Swami in Tamil, "Appa, ivanukku aalamarathoda ashrama amayanumnu ambal solluchi, nee or aalamaram vechirukalla adhu thana ivanudun paaren." He was telling in Tamil, "Devi told him that under a banyan tree a huge ashram will happen for this Swami. You have one banyan tree in your ashram. Can you take him and show? Is that the banyan tree Ambal showed him? And I promise, I tell you, I have not told Tiruchi Swami that I had that darshan at that time. I really did not tell Tiruchi Swami. I actually had darshan, but I did not tell him." He says, "Devi showed him with a huge banyan tree, the ashram will happen. Can you show your banyan tree and find out whether that is the banyan tree this Swami is looking?" I was shocked. Then I understood, being a slave of great beings is not suffocation, it is protection and inheriting their wealth.
I was searching for the bani entry all over the Bangalore. Those days, devotees, they know at least 100 places we visited in search of the bani entry. Anyhow, I went and saw that Shivapuri Swami's ashram bani entry and said, no, this is not the bani entry. I came and reported back to him. Then he said, all right, wait, I'll find out. I'll find out which bani entry. Finally, his disciple, one of his disciples, was searching for the banyan tree. He told the disciple, you try to search all the big banyan trees all around. In Mysore Road itself, there is another one, Dodda Aldamara. He even sent me there. And I said, no, not this banyan tree. I saw in vision. First, I did not reveal to him. After he revealed, Devi showed him. Then I told him that, yes, I had the darshan and vision and still it's there in my being as like a print. Then he sent me to different banyan trees and it was not matching. Then finally, that devotee who owns that land, in his dream, Paramashiva appears and tells that I am staying in Omkar Hills to go and meet me. And Tiruchi Swami tells, all right, you go and stay in Omkar Hills. Exactly that few days he sends me there. And the devotee comes and meets me in Omkar Hills. Then I brought the devotee to Tiruchi Swami and he said, right, now go and see. And then I went and saw the banyan tree and that's the banyan tree. Then after that, I wanted all of you to know, Tiruchi Swami personally visited our ashram and blessed. Not only Shivapuri Swami came, Tiruchi Swami also came personally, physically and blessed. Nobody knows. Very few people only know. He came and personally blessed and he only said, Swayambida Ulunga Puja Bandhu, Kapathiru. He told, seeing our Shivalinga in Tamil, Swayambida Ulunga Puja Bandhu, Kapathiru. Swayambu, take care of it well and do pujas properly. It will do all the good things and protect you forever. Nalla valarum. Till he lived in the body, Tiruchi Swami was the godfather. Every step I'll go and consult and every step he personally guided me. I want you to know even the trust registration he directed. He got involved and guided me. Hey, trust pananunda. Olunga rasidalam kuduthu kanakku velakkalam vechikidanum. And I still remember he himself will send some of his disciples to guide me anything needed. And that simhasan, Nityananda Peeta simhasan in Adi Kailasa, the first simhasan I sat in 2003, January 1st, was personally made by him and gifted. He called his disciples, his followers, and asked them to make with his design. He designed it, made it, and gifted. And then for the next simhasana also, that Panja Brahmas, that Brahma, Vishnu, Rudra, Isanan, the deities, I took it to him, he blessed it. And then he put his hand on my head and said, you are Parashakti. You can sit on Panja Brahma. Because Guru has to authorize to sit on Panja Brahma Asana. He himself is a Siddha Purusha, so he used to have that Panja Brahma Asana. And Guru has to bless. He blessed and said, you can sit on Panja Brahma Asana. And radiate Devi Parashakti. In every level, the way he took care of me, the way he organized everything, is more than a godfather. Not just guru. Guru and godfather. Everything. When I was near him, even physically, I just know that he is a devi. I never felt he is a male. He is just Devi. Parashakti. I just know he is a Devi. Parashakti.